Yes, ma'am. Maybe any other period, ma'am. This is second period, ma'am. Advanced, ma'am. हाँ जी, थैंक यू मैम, थैंक यू. एडमिट कर देना. यस बेटा खुशी, प्लीज कम टू दिस साइड बेटा, दिस साइड. दिस साइड इज कंप्लीटली, दैट्स अप टू यू. स्विच ऑन द एटलीस्ट लाइट एट द बैक साइड बेटा. मानव पुट इट बैक लाइट as you wish, okay, no problem. You can have that seat, that seat. These all are yours. Is it well? Wherever you feel comfortable, you can. Yes, no, nice. It's got closer though. You can have that seat. So, okay, last time we discussed about the nuclear size, okay, nuclear density. We have completed, na, beta. And I think one more topic we completed last time, that was I think mass defect. Yes, so three topics that we last time completed. I will be just for 1 minute having the recapitulation of these points, then I will move ahead beta. Regarding beta nuclear size, we were having the relationship that between R, this is equal to R naught a raised to power 1/3. R naught was our empirical constant, and it was regarded as 1.2 Fermi, and this was 1.2 into 10 raised to power minus 15 meters. Regarding the derivation part, beta, what we can do, you know the derivation part or not, all of you, beta Kushi? Pizza. Derivation part is clear or not? Absolutely clear. It should be. So we just have to say that the volume of the nucleus, this is directly dependent upon the mass number a beta. Volume means 4/3 pi r cube. This is the volume for the spherical object. This was said to be proportional to capital A. 4/3 and pi on account of being constant. R cube is proportional to beta a, or you can say that R is proportional to a raised to power 1/3 beta. And we can now eliminate this proportionality constant. We can put that proportionality constant. This is R naught a raised to power 1/3. The direct meaning was that beta, larger the number of nucleons present inside the nucleus, larger will be the size of the nucleus. So number of nucleons is directly indicated by a. Higher the number of nucleons, higher will be the volume. So in this manner we were having the direct dependence of the volume on the mass number a. So this is really just the recapitulation. I'm not going into the too much details. After the this video, we last time discussed the idea of the nuclear density also. Nuclear density, beta, roughly speaking, it is round about 10 raised power 13, 11 to 13 times more than that of the ordinary matter we come across in our daily life. So regarding the nuclear density, like any other density, beta, you can say that nuclear density rho, mass per unit volume, we can say beta. Beta, dear children, regarding the mass of the proton we have discussed in detail, mass of the neutron we have discussed in detail, and beta, having the mass of the nucleon with us, we can say that a nucleon can be considered to have a mass of 1.66 10 raised power minus 27 kg, one nucleon. Maybe proton, maybe neutron, collectively taken. And imagine that here in this nucleus about which we are talking, we have a number of nucleons as a is the mass number. So dear all, a multiplied by the mass of single nucleon minus 27 divided by volume, this is quite in front of you, this is your 4 by 3 pi r cube beta. Now I will be substituting for this r beta. So 3a 1.66 10 raised power minus 27 divided by 4, pi is already constant, c r beta. This is r naught a raised to power 1 by 3 beta. So I may have r naught a raised to power 1 by 3 cube of this term beta. Dear all, this is 3a 1.66 10 raised power minus 27 divided by 4 pi r naught cube of this term. Cube and cube root will get cancelled and it will be simply a. Now after beta, you can see well on this side 3 is constant beta and this a, this is going to be cancelled in the denominator and the numerator. 1.66 is constant, 10 raised to the minus 27 is constant, 4 pi r naught, all these are constants. Then we can say that this nuclear density 2.37 10 raised to the power 17 kilogram per meter cube. This is the order of the nuclear density. You can again see this is independent of any variable. All are constants on the right hand side of this expression. So whichever material you can choose, any material you can have with you, that will give you beta the constant value of the nuclear density. Beta nuclear density is not at all going to vary. So in this manner, this was just a recapitulation of the previous concept we have considered or discussed in detail. The last point we discussed last time, that was beta regarding the mass defect beta. Mass defect beta. Let us devote 1 or 2 minutes on the mass defect also. We know that beta, when we talk about the nucleus consists of protons and neutrons inside it beta. Protons and neutrons, they have the fixed number present in the fixed nucleus. Supposingly, I have X, Z, A. Z is the number of protons and A minus Z, this is the number of neutrons. Now, beta, suppose if we talk about this element, atom of the element rather, then these are the protons present, these are the neutrons present. Imagine the situation when these are not paired inside the nucleus. These are outside all. One proton has a mass of say mp, m for the mass, p for the proton. Single proton has mass mp, z is the number of protons here, so z into mp it will become. Then beta, mass of the neutron mn, and a minus z is the number of neutrons present beta. So mass of the neutrons collectively, all neutrons, it will be there. We will add these two terms. Again, I am reminding you beta, when we are not packing the neutrons and the protons inside the nucleus, these are just outside the nucleus, then this is the total mass before we pack them inside the nucleus. Individual masses we consider. Then beta, imagine the situation that this is here the nucleus, photograph of the nucleus taken at any instant of time, and these are the protons and neutrons present in it beta. Now if we consider that capital M is the mass of this nucleus taken separately after packing, now what we do, we pour the neutrons and protons inside this beta and we then finally find out the mass of the nucleus. So this mass, this does not come to be equal to this. So this difference beta, this is called mass defect, and we can denote it by small, rather delta M you can say. So this is mass defect. If I go one step beyond this mass defect, I will come to the conclusion that maybe there is some loss of mass. Where that mass has gone, We have discussed our famous Einstein's mass energy relationship in our 11th standard, and there we said that energy E, this is equal to delta mc square beta. So with this loss of mass, it appears in the form of energy to bind the nucleons present inside the nucleus. So this energy, this can be called as beta binding energy. So dear children, in this manner we can have the idea of mass effect. Is it now all clear to all dear children beta? Should I move ahead now? So beta, my next topic over here after this discussion, this one, all these ideas are very important beta. Generally question is there in the examination from this section of the syllabus. Let me beta have now alpha, beta and gamma particles, how these were detected, what are their basic properties and all that beta. Now beta, as per our nucleus is concerned, we always talk about beta Rutherford's experiment. We get so much valuable information from Rutherford's experiment, maybe regarding the radius, nuclear radius, maybe regarding the arrangement of the electrons inside the atom and all that. Now with a Rutherford and his associates or co-workers, it doesn't mean ki those persons are workers, these are the research fellows working with that person. Suppose I am working in some particular field and all of you are accompanying me, so you will also be involved in that process. So dear Rutherford's experimental setup beta, it led to one important fact that if we have some radioactive material and we place that radioactive material in a lead cavity, you might have seen that so many times we take the lead cavity, lead block. Lead is very good absorber of the radiations. It absorbs the radiations. When we are placing maybe this radioactive substance inside this lead cavity beta, radiations coming to this side and in the bottom direction, these will be absorbed by the lead block. And radiations which will be beta moving in this direction, these radiations will not at all be absorbed. These are expected to go as such. So these, this was your beta lead block, and this is beta source of radioactive radiations beta. Beta, बहुत ध्यान से एक बार फिर से बेटे concentrate करेंगे. What do we mean by radioactive substance, radioactivity, radioactive radiations and etc. All that. Beta, heavy nuclei, especially heavy nuclei, in order to become stable, heavy nuclei are generally unstable. In order to become stable, they emit beta radiations of one nature or other nature beta. These radiations are emitted so that the heavy nucleus, it may become stable. When these radiations are automatically emitted without any external support, that is called spontaneous emission beta. I'm using the word spontaneous. Spontaneous emission. Spontaneous emission means ki itself, apne aap, without any aid. We have a heavy nucleus. Usme se apne aap bete alpha, beta, gamma ya koi aur radiations jo hai, these are getting emitted just to attain stability. We have not forced that nucleus to emit these radiations. That is called spontaneous emission. And when you force that nucleus with the help of some external tool, external agency or external device to emit the radiations according to you, then that is called beta stimulated emission. So beta spontaneous means apne aap, without any aid. Stimulated means we are forcing that nucleus to emit the radiations because we want the nuclear reaction to take place according to our calculations and all that. Now, radioactivity. The term radioactivity, it means beta emission of radioactive materials, alpha, beta, gamma, etc., in order to attain the stability. Why these are called beta radioactive beta? Because these radiations, these when emitted by such type of nuclei beta, these do not lose the properties immediately after getting radiated, especially related to the nucleus, heavy nucleus. So these radiations, when these are emitted, they cause some sort of damage even to the human cells or live cells or the cells you have discussed in your cell biology. Now, suppose this is the lead block. This is the source of alpha particles. What Rutherford did was that he placed a metallic plate on this side and another metallic plate on this side. This plate, he made this plate as positively charged. And this plate, this was made negatively charged by Rutherford and his companions. When this positive and negative charge plates were arranged, then few of the radiations, they got deflected towards this negatively charged plate, and a few of these radiations, these got deflected towards this positive plate in this manner, and remaining few, they were going undeviated. At that time, depending upon the nature of this negative plate, negative charge will attract only positive charges. So these radiations were said to have positive charge upon them. And these radiations, these were at that time said to have the negative charge on them. Because these were not deflected, these were termed as neutral one. No charge was available with them. So in this manner, when there was no charge on these radiations, negative on these and positive on these negatively charged particles, these were called beta particles, and the positively charged radiations, these were called alpha particles, and these neutral radiations, these were termed as gamma rays or gamma radiations as such. So, on the basis of this small experiment, Rutherford and his companions were able to differentiate between the different type of radiations, especially related to the charge present on them. So, let us have some of the basic properties of these alpha, beta, and beta gamma radiations. Let us discuss these one by one. First of all, alpha rays. Alpha rays, as here it is quite evident that these are having first of all positive charge on them. They have positive charge and they have a mass equal to the mass of the helium nucleus. They have the mass equal to helium nucleus. And after this positive charge present on the alpha particles, it was twice the charge present on the proton plus 2e. This was the charge present on them. And if I go further with the properties with it, you can well imagine when this is having positive charge with it, we definitely can say that the radiation having this positive charge, when it is made to pass through some region of space, such that the space is comprising air or any other medium, this positively charged particles, when passing through air, it will ionize that particular medium. So I just mean to say that beta, they have ability to ionize the medium. These are having the ability to ionizing the medium. And beta, one estimate is there. This is very important point, beta. One estimate is there if we have the air column of width 7 cm, it will be roughly this much, 7 cm air column. Then beta, this particular alpha particles, when these are made to pass through the air column, these will make 20,000 ion pairs. You can well imagine, suppose I have, this is my alpha particle, and I make this alpha particle to pass through air. This is the surrounding air. When it will pass through air, it will create 20,000 ion pairs before dying out. Dying out, matlab, it will not die at all otherwise. It will lose its energy and it will become zero energy particle. So beta dear, if it is ionizing the medium, then we must talk about its penetrating power also. We must be knowing that what are its penetrating abilities. So dear children, up to maximum 77 cm of air column, it will beta penetrate. After that, it cannot penetrate. This is possible when it is having maximum amount of energy available with it. 7 cm, not 17. Let me once again have this point beta discussed. Suppose we have air column, pure air column, the composition of the air you know well. When the alpha particle will be passing through that air, maximum depth up to which it can penetrate is 7 cm. Beyond that, it will not survive, because beta, when it will be penetrating, it is beta making ion pairs. Its energy is used in creating the ion pairs or ionizing the medium through which it is passed. Imagine if it is having more energy, then the ion pairs will be created at a fast rate, and it will be attenuated at a fast rate also, beta. So taking into account all those parameters, it has been calculated that maximum in case of air, it can penetrate up to 7 cm. Rest of the materials, that depends upon the nature of the material, that what is the composition of the material through which we are making it to pass. Then very important property regarding the alpha particles, beta, that alpha particles, they possess a range of velocities. 1.4 into 10 raised per 7 meter per second to 2.1 into 10 raised per 7 meter per second. You can see this range. Approximately 10 times less than the velocity of light. These are the radiations. These should travel with the velocity of light, but approximately 10 times less, just because of a high amount of charge present with them and large mass of the alpha particles. So they are to ionize the medium also through which they are passing. That is why their speed becomes beta, slightly less than that of speed of light in the air. Then furthermore, as it is evident from this experimental setup itself, it is deflected by the positively and negatively charged plates. It is getting deflected, and so it will be deflected by the electric as well as the magnetic fields also. So you can add these properties also. These are deflected by positive and negative plates. This is visible to you, and this is deflected by electric field and magnetic field also. So beta, these are the basic properties of the alpha particles, and this is how beta we can manage these properties also. Any problem regarding these properties, beta? Should we move ahead? This is electric field and magnetic field. When the charged particle will be moving through the electric field, electric force will be acting on it, electrostatic force rather Coulomb force, and when it will be passing through the magnetic field, then with a moving charge is equivalent to a current, then you can well imagine that your Q, V, B, sine theta and all that will be applicable, and you will get the amount of the force as well as the direction in which the particle will get deflected. Clear, beta? This is with a deflected by the positive and negative plates. These are the positive and negative plates. So this is a positively charged plate, beta. This is negatively charged plate. If you have positively charged plate, that will repel alpha particles. If you have negatively charged plate, that will attract alpha particles. This is the effect, beta. Clear, beta? Then, beta, let us begin with the properties of beta particles. Beta particles, beta, loosely speaking, these are called electrons also. Beta particles, loosely speaking, these are called electrons also. Beta particles. Let us have few properties of beta particles. First, they have mass equal to the mass of the electron and the charge equal to the charge on the electron. These are basically beta electrons. So you can say that mass of electron, this may be considered as the mass available with the beta particles, beta. And regarding the charge on the beta particles is equal to minus E. This is a minus 1.6 into 10 raised to the minus 19 coulomb, beta. So this is the amount of charge. Now, beta, dear children, electron, this is very light in comparison to the helium nucleus, beta. Helium nucleus, it was actually having more mass. Then due to this factor, beta, your beta particle, it has a speed more than that of your alpha particles. This can have the speed approximately beta 2.9 × 10⁸ meter per second. This is beta not exactly, but nearly equal to the velocity of light. Why this small change? Or why this difference of 0.1? Because beta particles are negatively charged. When these will pass through a medium, they possess ionizing power. Ionizing power. So the medium through which beta particles will pass, they will ionize the medium through which they will be passing, beta. As the alpha particles were causing the ionizing effect, beta, they were creating around about 20,000 ion pairs. Here the charge on the electron is less than that on the alpha particle. It will create less number of the ion pairs in the medium through which it is passing, beta. And obviously, beta, because it is having the ionizing ability less than alpha particles, its penetrating power will be, beta, more in comparison to the alpha particles, beta. So we can say that, beta, it have more penetrating power, more in comparison to alpha particles. So after this, beta, we have still another important property, beta. These are deflected by positively and negatively charged plates, as it was clear. These are deflected by positive and negative plates, beta. And finally, beta, these are also deflected by electric field and beta magnetic field. So beta, these are the few important properties of your beta particles. Again, beta, if I brush up the things, I will be just saying that beta particles are fast moving electrons, beta. They have less mass in comparison to the alpha particles. They have more penetrating power. They have less ionizing power. They are deflected by electric and magnetic fields. They are deflected by positive and negative plates, beta. And beta, dear children, finally speaking, their charge is there, mass is less in comparison to the alpha particles. That is why, beta, their speed, this is more. One, the factor is that ki the particle is very light, and secondly beta we can also say that your beta particle on account of being very light beta and on account of having the less ionizing power, it will have beta more speed. Clear to all beta? Then beta, finally speaking, let us talk about beta gamma particles or gamma rays and conclude this particular topic. Let us have that discussion beta. Gamma radiations or gamma particles beta. Gamma radiations. Dear students, regarding the gamma radiations, first of all, no charge is present. How we come to know that no charge is present? Because they were going undeflected on the application of the electric and the magnetic field. They have no charge, or you can say that these are pretty neutral. They have speed exactly equal to the speed of light, 3×10⁸ meters per second beta, and beta, they have zero ionizing power, because they possess no charge, they have no ability to ionize the medium. Then if their ionizing ability is zero, they possess maximum penetrating power. Beta, this point is of very large use or importance in our nuclear science or physics. Why beta? Beta, in order to have the properties of the nucleus discussed in detail or studied in detail, we have two types of particles, neutrons and gamma rays. Neutrons are neutral, gamma rays are neutral beta. So they possess the ability to penetrate maximum inside the nucleus. Otherwise, if you will have alpha particle, beta particle, or any other charged particle, suppose this is the nucleus with me, I want to know about the composition of the nucleus, I have this projectile particle with me. If it is having some charge, then this large positive charge, it will do something with this charge. What something will be done, this is all known to us. Your electric or Coulomb's force is there, and all the other relevant forces are there. We don't need to repeat again and again and again. Imagine once again, this is the nucleus. Now this time I have this neutral projectile particle. Because it is neutral, it can penetrate maximum inside the nucleus. And by using this as a probe, we can study maximum about the nucleus. Clear, beta? So they are not deflected by electric and magnetic fields with it because they are neutral. These are not deflected by electric field and magnetic field. They are not deflected by your positively and negatively charged plates with it. So beta, dear children, these are few important properties of your alpha particles, beta particles, and beta gamma particles. Are all these properties clear, beta? Let us proceed further with alpha, beta, and gamma decay general equations with it. Then I will come to the laws of your radioactive disintegration. Let us see this, beta. You can write the heading, beta. Alpha, beta, and gamma emission, inki general equations beta. Alpha emission equation, how it will beta proceed. Imagine this is our XZA nuclear state, and alpha particle is being emitted. This is called parent nucleus beta. Alpha particle beta, basically your helium nucleus He2O4. When alpha particle it will give out, the new nucleus formed will be called as daughter nucleus. It is having atomic number 2 short, you can see, and mass number 4 short in comparison to the parent nucleus. Obviously, here you can either write alpha particle or helium nucleus and beta, it will be accompanied by some amount of energy that will be given out in this nuclear reaction or nuclear transmutation reaction beta. So this is your equation for the alpha emission beta. Then beta, keep one thing in mind beta, z minus 2 plus 2, z, atomic number conserved on both the sides, a minus 4 plus 4, a. So conserved on both the sides, we are to keep in mind the conservation of a as well as z. Mass energy that will go on side by side, that we will talk later on. So presently in these equations, we are to take into account z and a especially. Clear? Then beta emission. Beta particle, beta, basically your electron. This is x, z, a, beta negative emission hua. Dear students, this is your parent nucleus. This is daughter nucleus. Atomic number gets increased by one. Mass number remains same. And you can say, beta, this is your beta particle. Again, focus. Z plus 1 minus 1 is equal to Z. A plus 0 is equal to beta A. And along with this beta, beta particle, we were having a antineutrino also. We have discussed this equation already in our previous periods. Along with it, some amount of energy will be given out beta. So when talking about beta, such type of equations once have a site on A and Z and see that whether on the two sides these are same or not. So again, this plus this is equal to this. This plus this is equal to this. It possesses zero atomic number, mass number. It is just a packet of energy. Spin it is having. Then, beta gamma emission. Beta gamma emission, bahut hi dhyan se suniyega beta once again. Alpha emission completed. Beta emission completed. After the completion of alpha and beta emission, the daughter nucleus, which is newly formed, that is not in the ground state, that is in the excited state. I mean to say that that daughter nucleus, which is newly formed, it is possessing energy more than the ground state energy. That extra amount of energy is released in the form of gamma rays. So gamma emission, chaliye bete next time complete kar lenge, no problem. So thank you all beta. Try to revise the things well in time. Thank you all beta once again.